Hello. From March 5th to March 11th, 2021, the Brazil-Canada Chamber of Commerce will be hosting the 15th edition of the Brazil-Canada PDAC, taking place during the 2021 PDAC Virtual Convention, which includes a series of events focused in the Brazilian mineral exploration and mining industries. I'm Carolina Albernaz, CEO of the Brazil-Canada Chamber of Commerce, and I'm here today with Peter Tagliamonte, President and CEO of Belosun Mining, a mining company focused on generating long-term sustainable value for its shareholders by developing the Volta Grande Gold Project located in Pará State. So Peter, welcome, and thank you very much for being here today.
Well, thank you, Carolina. It's a pleasure to be speaking to you from the PDAC 2021.
And so why don't we start by you telling us a little bit about Belosun and the Volta Grande Gold Project?
Okay, well, thank you. So the Volta Grande Project, obviously in your introduction, it's located in Brazil. Pará State is where it's located. And as you mentioned, Pará State is the second largest mining state in Brazil. It has a lot of mining infrastructure, some of the largest mines in the world. It is a very supportive government for mining. And Volta Grande has really benefited from this strong infrastructure and support of mining in Pará State. Volta Grande is the largest undeveloped gold project in Brazil. We currently have over 6 million ounces of resources, 3.8 million of reserves. The project has been fully permitted. We received our environmental license approval in Brazil. That's called an LP. The preliminary license that was approved. The construction license was approved as well. That's called an LI or installation license in Brazil. We had to complete an indigenous study and that was submitted and approved in December of 2020. So the project is completely permitted. There are some administrative items that we still have to do. And obviously COVID has impacted significantly the rate at which things get done. But Volta Grande and Belosun are a project that has a big resource. It's fully permitted. And we're looking forward to 2021 as being a extremely transformational year for the company.
So now that's all permitting, so what's next status of the project? What's next for this project?
Okay, so the next steps of the project are that we continue to work with our local communities, the indigenous communities, the local communities, municipalities, and the government. It's, you know, shareholder inclusion as well as stakeholder inclusion is very important to us. So we have been working very hard to make sure that all stakeholders will benefit from the Volta Grande project. As I mentioned, our indigenous study was approved by FUNAI. It was deemed to be apt at the end of this year. We have a couple more meetings to do to explain the project to the indigenous communities. That's been slightly delayed by COVID-19 impact, but those things should be completed. And we're looking forward to, as I mentioned, hopefully starting construction with all shareholders benefiting and participating in the Volta Grande project sometime in the latter part of 2021.
Perfect. So operations, construction starting later on this year.
That is our hope and our expectation, yes.
Perfect. So, and then how important, you've been going to PDAC for many, many years. You are a very seasoned executive in the mining industry. How important is this convention for the mining community and to connect the mining players in your perspective?
Well, it's an interesting question. In 2021, because obviously we're doing this virtually, and I think the mining community and, you know, businesses around the world are adjusting to the new reality of you know, lockdowns and virtual meetings. I can say that the PDAC has been a part of the mining industry for many, many years. It was always a good meet and participate and learn about companies, and it was a very socially interactive convention. So it has been a tremendous benefit throughout the years for mining companies, mining professionals, as well as investors. I think 2021, we're doing something different, but hopefully it's beneficial to the companies and investors as it has been in the past. And hopefully next year, 2022, we're back into the same social interactive environment that we have been in the past. But it's a tremendous organization. People like yourself, it allows us to connect with the countries around the world. You know, as your viewers know, the PDAC connects, you know, many countries from around the world that have interest in exploration and mining, as well as government agencies from all levels. So I think it's a tremendous opportunity and benefit to the mining community.
Amazing. Yeah, no, that's definitely going to be a very different year, but we hope that with the online, it's quite a little bit different, we'll be able to continue connecting everyone and the companies with the Brazilian opportunities and the Brazilian government. This is very exciting. Thank you very, very much, Peter, for being here today. Belo Sun Mining is a silver sponsor of our 15th edition of the Brazil Canada at PDAC events. And we are thrilled that we're able to have this chat here with you, Peter. So stay tuned as the Brazil Canada at PDAC series of events starts this coming Friday, March 5th, with a full program focused on opportunities and trends for the Brazilian mineral exploration and mining industry. Don't miss it. And for more information and registration, please go to www.braskenchamber.org/PDAC2021. We look forward to seeing you there. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Caroline.